Hello everybody and thank you much for watching. This is me, Mr. P. This is another episode in a series Raspberry Pi Server with Samsung DeX. In this episode I will show you how you can set up Docker and Portainer on your DiePi OS, and obviously everything will be done through Samsung DeX. So let's start by connecting to our DiePi OS server using Termux. To do that, you type SSH space root at followed by IP address of your Raspberry Pi, press enter, enter the password that you created in a previous episode. Here we are, I'm successfully connecting into a DiePi OS. There's two ways for you to install Docker and Portainer. First of all, we need to go into DiePi-software, press enter. The first way is go into browse software and go through the list of over 200 services that you can install on your DiePi OS and find where is hiding the Docker and Portainer in this list. Or you can go back and go into search software and type Docker and press enter. And here we are, we have three results came back with the word Docker matching. First one is Docker Compose, which we will not install. We will install 162, which is Docker, build, ship, and run distributed applications, basically containers. And then 185, which is Portainer, simplified container management system for Docker and a standalone host. There is a Portainer and there is Portainer agent. Portainer agent usually is installed inside the Docker services, Docker servers, where you want to manage them like a nodes with a master Portainer, which is, that's what we're going to install. We're going to install a master Portainer. To select, you just use arrow keys and press space to select. Put the asterisk next to 162 and 185. Then using tab, select OK, press enter. Go all the way down to install and press enter, and you will get the brief information telling you exactly what's going to happen. So we're going to install Docker and Portainer. And please note that software services will be temporarily controlled, stopped by DiePi OS during this process. In other words, means that every time you will install anything in the future from the list that I showed you just a couple of seconds ago, all the services will be stopped. So obviously SSH and BNC will function because you need to have option to control the system while it's still installing the software, just in case if you want to stop it. Anyway, we will carry on installing Docker and Portainer. So using arrow key tab button, I will select OK and press enter. And now DiePi OS will go and fetch all the files that it needs to install Docker. And once the Docker is installed, it will go and run the command to install a Portainer or run a Portainer contained inside Docker system. This process usually takes between 1 to 2 minutes. All depends on how fast your hard drive is, your microSD card, and how fast is your home broadband speed. So I will be back when this is done. Once inside Termux window, you see root at and whatever host name you gave to your Raspberry Pi. That means installation has been completed. To double check that the Docker is definitely installed, you can type Docker and it's going to give you a bunch of lines showing up, or you just type Docker space V, which stands for version, and you should see Docker version. Mine at the time of recording is 20.10.11. We'll check if a Portainer is running. You type Docker space PS. It will give you a list of all the containers that are currently running inside the Docker. At the moment, we have one, which is Portainer-CE, stands for Community Edition, which is a free version. And I can see here that this pointing 9002 port to internal 9000. Portainer requires port 9000, but the Docker sends the port 9002 to attach to port 9000. That's how we're gonna sort all the services in the future that we will run inside the Docker, because most of the services that we will run on this mini on the Raspberry server will require same port. So for example, if you have three or four services that require port 80, we can map port 81, 82, and 83 to be your port 80. And this obviously Docker will do the rest and point to the right service. Anyway, so it's port 9002. Let's open the internet browser and enter IP address of your Raspberry Pi. In my case is 192.168.178.61 and the port number 9002. If I click on that, the setup window for portainer.io shows up. You can leave a username as you want, admin, or you can change it. I leave it as admin. It just doesn't bother me. I'll enter the password that I want to have for my Portainer instant. It needs to be 8 characters or more. And here we go. A green tick means that my password entered correctly both times. And I'm just going to click create user. And now I'm going to say, yeah, remember. And now we need to click get started. In the future, if you want me to show you how to set up, a second Raspberry Pi and make like a Docker swarm kind of cluster, let me know in the comment section below and I'll show you what happens when you click add environment. But at the moment, we're going to do get started. If I click on that, I'll see one blue whale, which represents a Docker instant. And here we are. We have one Docker instant running on the Raspberry Pi. If I click on that, I'll get information exactly about this Docker instance, which is just telling me that this environment local. We're going to change that in a second. It has 4 CPUs, 8 gigabytes of RAM. It's run standalone version of 2010.11. It's just, this URL is how the Docker system connects to other services, to other containers. We have stacks, containers, images, volumes, and network. Under stacks is a different way for you to set up the container. You just paste a script in here and the Docker does the rest. I'll show you that in the future. Under containers, you will see all the list of containers that you currently have on your Docker system. At the moment, we have only one. And it's under label running, which is fantastic. It means everything is great. The first icon is going to show you logs, exactly what's happening with the system. This log is auto refreshes. So if you click on this, it's not going to auto refresh now. That's great. Go back in containers. Second one is just information about this container. It gives you a bunch of information that where the data has been stored, which driver is using, when it's been created, what name, and etc. Just go back here. The third icon gives you a usage of this container itself, not actual Raspberry Pi, but just that container. So right now I set to update every 1 second. As you can see right now, container using around 1% of CPU is currently doing just 300 kilobytes over network traffic. And this is most of the containers that I'll show in the future, like for example, Plex. When you're trying to watch a movie of the Plex server running on your Raspberry Pi Docker, this obviously will spike up. But there is other containers I'll show you how to set it up, which will give you a bit more in-depth information about your Raspberry Pi server. Next one is images. And at the moment we have one image, which is called Portainer/Portainer-TE Community Edition and semicolon latest. I'll explain all this in the future when we're going to start setting up the containers, what exactly this means. But in a nutshell, this is imagine like an APK file on Android or ISO file on Windows. This is like installation file, which you can use to create other containers, or you can create multiple containers. So even if we have one container, Portainer running, I can basically go add a container and I can say that I want, should show up here, doesn't, probably it's a buggy. I can basically create another Portainer instance and call it Portainer 2 using the same image in here. So this is, like I said, it's like an ISO or APK file on Android. Under networks, each container will use most of the time bridge network, or you can use host network. Bridge network is more useful because you can map the different ports to different services. Host is basically going to use your IP address without any ports follow after that. Some of the containers will set up their own networks, and I'll show in the future what that is. Under volumes is going to give you a list of all the volumes or locations on your Raspberry Pi where the container is storing the data. Most of the containers will create their own volumes inside docker-data folder and then /volumes. And it's great for very quick containers or something that you don't really need to access the files inside it. But for example, setting up like a FileZilla container, you want to access the files, what FileZilla is doing. So I will show how to do basically manual mapping, because the volumes/Portainer data, this folder is read and write permissions is restricted for you. So it's only accessible via Docker. And I don't suggest to go there and start messing around these when they've been done automatically by the Docker and Portainer itself. Under thens, I don't really use this much, just showing you exactly what is going on or what's happened. And under host, it gives you a bit more information about your Raspberry Pi. So if we go back to home, as you can see right now, it says local, and this is my Docker instance. And before wrapping this video up, I'll show you a couple of housekeeping things I suggest for you to do before basically ending this video. So first of all, it says local. I don't really want to have a local here. So we're going to go inside environment, inside the local, click on that and change local to say Dex Pi. I'm going to click update environment. Let's go back right now to home. And now I have a Dex Pi instead of saying local. When you, let's say in the future, have a multiple running, they're all going to say local, 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 local. So you won't going to be that easy to find out which one is which. Right now, if you go under containers, and if I mouse over the port 9002 /9000, at the bottom left, you can see it says http://0.0.0.0/9002. Technically, if I click on this, I should open the Portainer because it should open the Raspberry Pi IP address followed by a port number, but doesn't because it defaults to 000. To do that, we're going to back into the environment. And in here, I'll click on DexPi. And now under public IP, I'm just going to enter 192.168.178.61, basically IP address of my Raspberry Pi. Obviously, you can create groups and tags. For one Docker instance, it doesn't really make the big of a difference. When you have, let's say, 2, 3, or 10, or 20 running, it's very helpful for you to create the tags. So right now, under environment, if I click on a Dex Spy, as you can see, I entered the IP address. If I go back to containers, I'll click on this. And now if I click on this, it's going to open the portainer, because what's happened, if I go back to this, I mouse over it, and in the bottom left corner right now, instead of showing four zeros, it shows me a correct IP address for my Raspberry Pi. So this is very useful. So I suggest to do this straight away when set up, because once you're going to have a lot of containers running here, trying to access the container information just by clicking on a port will not work, because IP address is just going to default to 0000. And the last thing, one I want to show you, if you go to my account, click on that, you have option to go light mode, dark mode, or high contrast mode. I suggest which one is you prefer. You just select on that which one you like and just click update. And while you're here, if you're not happy with the password you created, you can create the password here, but you cannot change the username. Well, actually, you can create a user, but I don't mess with that. I just leave as an admin, and that's fine by me. So this is how you get Docker and Portainer set up on your DiaPi server with Samsung Dex. In upcoming videos, we're going to start setting up the containers, and we're going to start using this full time with my Samsung Dex setup. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.